Today, we're going above the soil to take a closer look at the plants that we produce here at Reamer Family Farm and how moving from a monoculture row crops of corn and soybeans 10 years ago to now having diverse pasture mixes has allowed the land to thrive and in turn result in the exceptional tasting, nutrient-dense meat products that we now produce. So join me as we go out in the field with Bryce and Kalina, and we'll take a closer look.
Bryce, we're standing in a different field this week, right?
We are. We're standing in a field that's in our northernmost pasture. It's about 70 acres, and it's filled with different crops and different livestock than the field that we were in last week that was primarily grazed by cattle.
Yeah, it's a pretty stark difference here. I'm just looking at the plants, and they look way different than what we had last week. I can see it's up to your waist.
Yeah. Yeah, so this is an annual. It's a summer annual, as opposed to what we saw last week, which is a perennial plant. We looked at a pasture last week that just keeps growing year after year. This annual plant it grows 1 year. You plant it annually, and these cover crops here are doing a number of things, but primarily creating a great forage that will bale for the cattle to eat over winter, but also stabilizing the soil and sucking up nutrients and things like that. So Kalina is here to give her thoughts on what's growing out here. Can you show everybody what we have?
So this big grassy plant, it kind of looks like corn, but it is sorghum Sudan grass. And then down here, kind of looks like kale, is brassica.
That's the same family as like broccoli and cabbage and kale, like you said. Why do you have brassica in here?
Well, it's good with a lot of different plants in here too. It's good to have a diverse diet for the animals and different roots in the soil. So it's a whole good balance of soil diversity and the diet is very diverse for the animals.
So it's good for the things underground and above ground.
Yeah.
Everyone can see the cover crops that we're standing in right now, but what they can't see is behind me, which is not cover crops, right?
Right.
Should we head over there?
Sure. Yeah, so this just changed to crops that's more clover. This is clover. It's shorter, it's thick, you know, you got clover and grass, so you got legumes and your grasses in here, and that's just kind of like what we saw last week. So this is a perennial mix as opposed to that annual mix that we just came out of. You can see there's a lot more of this because this is a pasture that we don't overwinter cattle in, so it stays in good shape year after year. So out here, we can have we can still make hay off of this if we need some for winter, or we have sheep and chickens and pigs all out here grazing on this summer, and turkeys will be coming out next week.
So what are the roles of the plants here?
Well, the plants are good for a lot of reasons. They capture the carbon in the air and put it back into the soil, and then they also help to keep the soil in place. See, it's very thick here, and so there's lots of roots and keeping the soil in place much better than a row crop would because they're very spaced out.
And she didn't say anything about it being feed for livestock, which is awesome because she knows that we're grass farmers, right? And it actually sounds funny, but we're grass farmers, and then the livestock are basically tools that help us manage the grass, because the health of the soil and the animal, and then therefore you, all starts with healthy soil and grass. So the role of the plants, in addition to what she said, is to feed our animals, and the more diverse plants and healthy plants that we can grow, which whether they're perennials that grow every year or annuals that just we plant every year, it's to give our animals the nutrients they need to produce a really, really healthy and great tasting product for you.
Awesome. Kalina, I'm curious, what did this field look like when you moved back 10 years ago? Do you remember?
Yeah, I remember running through the corn, but I enjoy this so much more. But it used to be corn and beans every other year, trading off corn or beans. But this just looks so much more healthy, and there's always green on it. If there was corn or beans, there was lots of time during the year that was just dirt.
And you can use the same field for multiple purposes. When it's corn, it's just corn. The whole year, that's it. You never even get to walk in it. Here, we've got not only two different types of crops growing, but four different species of livestock out here using the same ground, and we can make hay off of it. So multi-use opportunities now with these kind of changes.
That's really great. And Bryce, when you were a kid, it was corn and row crops
even,
too, right?
Even back then, yeah.
So quite a bit of change in the last 10 years.
Yeah, there's been a lot of change, but so far so good. And we've seen a lot of positive outcomes from the ecology here, signs of life, new insects and butterflies stopping by and grassland birds that weren't here before. So we're pretty sure that we're on the right track.
Awesome. Earlier, you guys mentioned that the pastures are used to feed the cattle over winter, and we raise 100% grass-fed beef and lamb. So how do you guys do that, keep them eating the pasture even through a Wisconsin winter?
Well, yeah, the plants you just saw out there, the hay gets made, and this is what we use to feed them all winter. We take a couple cuttings. We bale it a couple times a year and then wrap it so it can be stored much better. And then the skid loader just comes and takes them out to where the cattle are.
Mm-hmm. It'd be a combination of the cover crops or the perennial pasture. We cut and bale both of those crops. And we have a plan for making sure to manage when it's time to cut it so that the plants are at the right stage so that they have the most energy. Just like when the cattle are grazing, we want them to graze it at the right height, the right size. For the most energy, we cut it at the same, with kind of the same philosophy, so that when you store store those plants over winter in these bags that don't let any air in, it basically turns into silage, ferments it, so that it's fresh and just like it was when we put it in here. Cattle eat that; it's very palatable, and then they keep growing all winter. So basically, they are eating the same pasture year round, and that's how they're 100% grass fed.
You only finish steers, right? We don't have any cows here, and that's to do with the pasture quality, right?
Well, yeah, we switched that just two, 3 years ago. We used to have cow-calf here, but now we just do beef finishing so that we can not only finish more beef for you, but also because we don't have to feed as many cows this hay over winter, and we have the right, our pastures have higher quality now, and so the cows don't actually need that much high quality. It's just the beef finishing steers.
Thanks. Just wanted to remind you all that if you have any questions throughout this series, please don't be afraid to ask. Send me a message, an email, just comment below. We'll get those questions answered for you. That's the benefit of knowing your farmer, is that we're here to answer your questions. The other thing that I wanted to remind you of is that we have on-farm tours available, and we've opened it up Thursday evenings. You can come get your meat and bring your family. It's one ticket for a carload or your family, however it is, and you just can enjoy the farm and walk around, see the animals, look at the plants, maybe pick yourself a little bouquet and look for the butterflies. You know, just take that time to connect with your food, connect with your family, and connect with us. We would love to get to know you more and to have you out here and to be able to answer those questions in person. So if you have any questions, let me know. You can find out more in the store. Other than that, stay tuned for next week's video, where we'll take a look at everyone's favorite, the charismatic creatures of the farm. We're going to look at wildlife and the animals themselves. So we'll see you next week. Until then, take care.